Hello everyone, Marie Colbert, Realtor with Virtual Real Estate Group here in Coquitlam, British Columbia, Canada. Amidst all of this COVID-19 madness, I did promise you guys that I would be doing videos other than just on the coronavirus and real estate. And so today's video is going to be the top questions to ask when you are purchasing a condo. Buying a condo is very different than buying a townhouse and very, very different than buying a single family home. There's a lot you want to know about the strata, the unit, what's included in all of that. So I've put together the top 14 questions to ask. So with that being said, the 14 questions just in advance, I will give them to you and then I'll kind of break them down one by one. But number one is, what is included in the maintenance fee? Number two is there a storage locker included? Number three is, how much is in the contingency reserve fund? Number four is there a depreciation report? Number five is, are there any special levies currently approved or proposed? And how much have you paid in special levies in the last 5 years? Number six is, when was the roof done? Number seven is the building on a boiler system or is there a hot water tank in unit? If there's a hot water tank in unit, how old is it? Number eight is, what does the insurance cover? And how much is the strata insurance deductible? Number nine are, what are the rules and bylaws? Number 10 is, does the building have history or any current lawsuits or litigation? Number 11 is, what are the amenities available? Number 12 is the building rain screened? Number 13 is, who is the property manager and what are they like? Is it self-managed? And number 14 is, do you have any idea who is above, below, and or besides me? And of course, what are they like? So, you know, with that being said, I'm going to start off with, if you are thinking about purchasing a condo, please, please, please make sure that you use a realtor that is very familiar with strata properties. Because as I mentioned, this is totally different. Strata documents are a completely different ballgame than purchasing a single family home. Townhouses, yes, it does go over, but you know, there's a lot more common property with condos, and just the type of building items and building assets are also different than townhouses. So make sure that when you are interviewing a realtor and you're talking to a realtor and you're considering about who to use as a realtor to help you purchase a condo, that you do use somebody that specializes in strata properties. And of course, if you're in the Lower Mainland, feel free to reach out to me anytime. But getting into this, so number one, what is included in the maintenance fee? So the reason why I asked this question is because for me specifically, I want to know whether or not gas is included. Some of these homes have gas stoves or maybe a gas fireplace, and so a lot of the time that gas fireplace can heat the whole unit during the winter time and maybe help to keep hydro bills down. So I want to know whether or not gas is included in the maintenance fee, but sometimes heat is included in the maintenance fee. You know, I want to know landscaping, snow removal, all these things, what's included in that maintenance fee. So number two, is there a storage locker included? The reason why I ask this question is because not all condos have a storage locker included. It's a huge selling feature for resale value. A lot of people have a lot of stuff, especially if you're downsizing from a bigger place. Having a storage locker is a huge bonus. I have a lot of clients that downsize and say, you know, where am I going to put the Christmas tree or the decorations or my snowboard and all these things? Maybe they don't want to put it in their closet with all of their coats and shoes and stuff like that. So is there a storage locker that's included? And then also just keeping in mind, how big is that storage locker? They do come in different sizes. So is it a full size, which is typically 6 feet high, 4 feet wide, and then 6 feet deep? Is it a half size locker that usually comes up to about the waist? And just verifying that that locker is actually included and possibly going to see it. So how much is in the contingency reserve fund is the next question. This is so, so important for strata properties. The contingency reserve fund is basically the strata savings account, their bank account. You know, making sure that you have a healthy contingency reserve fund is making sure that you have a healthy strata that's proactive, that's planning for capital projects, that is, you know, or has enough funding for emergency repairs, has a rainy day fund, all of these things. The contingency reserve fund holding up really well is very, very important to minimizing the risk for you as a homeowner to pay special levies. And this kind of ties into the next question. So is there a depreciation report? Not all buildings have a depreciation report. This is something that can be waived by the strata, but a depreciation report is great because it's basically a report that's prepared by a third-party engineer that assesses the building as a whole, all of the items in the building, like how old is the roof, you know, when was the last time it was painted, what's the state of all these things, and then they assess everything, and then they cross-reference it with the average lifespan for each item, and then they tell you when the expected time of repair is, and then how much that's likely going to cost. And then they cross-reference that with the contingency reserve fund just to see whether or not the strata, you know, has enough money and is planning properly to make sure that it's taking the depreciation of the building into consideration. And then that depreciation report will also estimate, you know, how did the maintenance fee hold up, or how do the maintenance fees hold up against all of this depreciation? Is it likely that the maintenance fee is going to have to increase? Is it likely that it's going to be funded by a special levy? So it gives different funding models as well, which is really, really, really helpful, just to make sure that you have a good idea of the financial state of the strata, and, you know, potential special levies or increases in maintenance fees that you might have to pay, or at least will want to plan for. So going on with number five, are there any special levies currently approved or proposed? The reason why I want to know this is because I want to know whether or not there's a special levy that is approved, what it's for, and of course, making sure that the seller is going to be the one that's responsible for that. One of the clauses that we add into our contracts is that any special levy that's approved prior to the completion date is going to be the responsibility of the seller. So the reason why we add that is because obviously the subject to strata documents is only relevant for the time of the subject removal. But what happens if a special levy gets approved after you've handed in your deposit, but before your completion? You know, you want to make sure that the seller's responsible for that and not you, because you weren't aware of that special levy at the time that you removed your subjects and handed in your deposit. So little things like that. And then again, you know, how much have you paid in special levies in the last 5 years? Asking the seller that, just so you get an idea of, you know, how the strata typically deals with things. You know, do they have enough in the contingency? If they're constantly special levying people, probably not. How much has that been? You know, were those projects big, big projects that you might not anticipate another special levy in the near future because they did, you know, the roof or the building envelope and things like that, and it was inevitable that they had a special levy, or what's that situation? So just assessing that. Number six, when was the roof done? This is a big project. A lot of the times you'll see a special levy come out of this. So you want to know what the age of the roof is. Average roof lasts around 20 to 25 years. So just giving yourself that time estimate on, like, okay, well, you know, when does it need to be done? Is it going to be in the immediate future? And then again, you know, making sure you have a rainy day fund just in case set aside, for planning and, things like that. So is the building on a boiler system, or is there a hot water tank in the unit? So this kind of ties back into what's included in the maintenance fee. So if the building is on a boiler system, that means that there's a centralized boiler system, usually in the parkade, that then feeds hot water to all of the units. Or the alternative is having a hot water tank in the unit. In that case, it would be the responsibility of the homeowner, and it's something that you as a homeowner would have to replace, and the average recommended lifespan is about 10 years. So if it's on a boiler system, hot water is included in the maintenance fee, and that's the responsibility of the strata to maintain that boiler system. If it's in your unit, it's going to be your responsibility. The pro of that is that you have complete control over your water. You're usually getting hot water faster. And if you have hot water issues, it's something that you personally can fix right away without going through strata. But it's just something to be aware of. So again, how old is that hot water tank as well? That's what you want to know, because as I said, average recommended lifespan is about 10 years. So you just want to know whether or not you're going to have to replace that in the near future. What does insurance cover, and how much is the strata insurance deductible? You just want to make sure that you're actually able to get your own insurance to cover that full deductible in the event that something is deemed your responsibility with regards to damage and insurance, and you need to make a claim. And then what does that insurance cover? So making sure that you're getting that strata insurance note and having your insurance broker review it in advance. This should be one of the subjects on your contract. I can't tell you how many realtors don't put a subject to insurance. It's so, so important, especially given all of the increases in premiums and increases in deductibles in BC recently. And if you have questions about that, I have another vlog on that as well. So check it out. Insurance is very important though, and make sure that you're aware of the strata's insurance, what it covers, and how much the deductible is. What are the rules and bylaws? So every single strata is different. They all have their own rules. They all have their own bylaws, but you want to know whether, you know, pets are allowed, whether rentals are allowed. Sometimes there are size, weight, or breed restrictions for dogs. Can Fido come with you? You know, can you have air conditioning in your unit? All of these things you want to know. It's a part of the lifestyle. You're moving in as, you know, an owner that's sharing a space with people, and everybody needs to follow certain rules and restrictions. So just be aware of that. Does the building have any history or current lawsuits? This is important because you just want to make sure that you know the state of the strata. What were those litigations for? If they are going through litigation, how much is legal going to cost? Legal can be quite expensive. Most of the time it comes out of the contingency, or it's going to be paid by form of special levy by the owners. So that's why it's something you want to know. You know, how much is that lawsuit and how long do they expect it to go on for, basically. Number 11, what are the amenities available? Tying back into what's included in the maintenance fee. Maybe there's a gym, maybe there's a pool, maybe there's a hot tub, just knowing what the building has to offer for you. Is the building rain screened? So this is a big one in the lower mainland. Rain screening basically provides breathability so that if water does penetrate, you're not going to see as much water damage because it's going to be able to breathe out of the building, in comparison to something face sealed, where if something does penetrate, it's hard for that water to breathe and get out. Rain screening was basically implemented post like 1996, but there was obviously some delay with regulations and mandates. So sometimes, you know, buildings up to about 2006, you might see still kind of lingering on that face sealed versus rain screening border. But for the most part, buildings post 2000, I would say, are all rain screened, making sure that when you do the subject to inspection that you're just verifying that it's a rain screened building. And if it's not, that you're just aware of it and what maintenance and precautions that they're taking to make sure that water damage doesn't become a huge issue. Also, you can check the strata documents to see whether the building's rain screen. Ask the listing agent. It's just a question that you should be asking just to make sure that you are aware of the state of the building and what things that you should potentially be concerned about. 13, who is the property manager and what are they like? So this is, you know, a question that you should ask, but take it with a grain of salt. I mean, to put it frankly, a lot of people aren't happy with their property managers, and it's because property managers have to deliver the hard news. But the property managers are basically there to support the Strata Council and give them recommendations and make sure that they're following things like the Strata Property Act. And so, is it self-managed? You want to know whether or not it's self-managed so that you can get an understanding of whether or not they are actually seeking proper counsel or if they're potentially just going rogue. Number 14, last one, is any idea who's above, below, and beside me? You want to know who your neighbors are, what they're like, you you know, are sharing walls with people, and obviously that's something to take into consideration. But I hope this answers all of your like commonly asked questions and why you should ask these questions. So just be aware again, guys, that strata properties are something that should be taken very seriously. If you are looking to buy a condo, I'm always here to help. Happy to help you with any questions that you have, and I hope that you use these questions when you are looking to purchase yourself. Marie Colberg, Realtor with Bridgewell Real Estate Group. I hope you guys have an absolutely fantastic day, and I will definitely keep posting more videos, so stay tuned for more of that. Have a good one.